Hello, in this video we want to talk about the philosophy of time and time travel. A theory of time usually involves three parts. First, it has a temporal ontology. In other words, it talks about what times exist, answering questions like, do the past and the things in the past exist? Do the future and the things in the future exist? The second part explains if it is an A theory, meaning that it thinks that the world is ordered by the past, the present, and the future, and that these concepts are real, or a B theory, meaning that these notions are only perspectival. Finally, it has an account on temporal passage. In other words, it will answer, does time really pass, or is it a matter of perspective? In this video, we will focus on two philosophical theories about time. We will first explain three-dimensionalism, and then move to four-dimensionalism. Finally, we will see whether time travel is compatible with these theories. Let's start talking about three-dimensionalism. Three-dimensionalism is also called presentism, because it argues that only present events and things exist. So a three-dimensionalist will talk about the past as having existed, and say that the future will exist. However, the only things and events that simply exist are the ones in the present. So three-dimensionalism is an A theory. It says that this distinction between past, present, and future is real. In other words, it claims that being present is a feature of an object, that the past and the future are not simply a matter of perspective. Finally, concerning temporal passage, three-dimensionalism holds a dynamic ontological change view. This sounds complicated, but it is very easy to understand. The idea is that time passes because what is present, the things and events that exist, change. So, in a prior present, things like the dinosaur existed. Now, we are a tiny part of the things that exist. However, in the future, instead of us, new things will exist, and these new things will also be in the present. This view of the dynamic ontological change is probably the most challenging to understand, so let's see another example. Now, imagine that this block is four-dimensional, and signals all points in space and time. So, three-dimensionalism will select a specific vertical section from the block, and claim that this is the present. Therefore, it will say that all the things that exist are the ones in this section. Finally, when asked about the beyond temporal passage, a three-dimensionalist will only move the section a little bit more to the right, towards the future.
Now let's take a look at four-dimensionalism. This can also be called eternalism. According to four-dimensionalism, we can imagine time as its own dimension. This sounds confusing, so let's make it simple. Our world as we think of it has three dimensions: length, width, and depth. Okay. So imagine our 3D world frozen in this exact present moment. Birds frozen in the air, cars stopped on the road. It looks different if we imagine the same world frozen 1 second later, and 1 second after that, and so on. According to 4Dists, time is made up of these frozen shots, each one split seconds apart. They are laid out across the dimension of time, and all exist simultaneously. Four-dimensionalists suggest that objects can persist through time. For example, the chair you are sitting on exists today, and existed for some time before that, and will continue its existence for some time into the future. Eventually, it may stop existing somewhere along the temporal dimension. But nothing ever ceases to exist entirely, because it can still be found in the past. So, four-dimensionalism is a B theory. It believes that time has a chronological order. T2 is later than T1 and earlier than T3. But it does not believe in the idea of an absolute present. The present is not special compared to the past or the future, because they all exist. The present is just another way of saying where we are along the time dimension. 4Dist opinions about temporal passage vary somewhat. Some adopt the static thesis, and others believe in the moving spotlight view. The moving spotlight view is the most intuitive. Like 3Dism, it says that what we experience is the present. This present moves along the time dimension, but the past, present, and future all continue to exist as we leave them behind and before we reach them. The static thesis is more controversial. It says that the present moment never changes, because what exists does not change. However, this can be seen as looking at 4Dism with a 3Dist understanding of the present.
At a quick glance, it would be easy to say that three-dimensionalism is not consistent with time travel, whereas four-dimensionalism is. Four-dimensionalism allows for time travel, as it argues that the universe is a four-dimensional space-time manifold. A time traveler can be seen like a streak through this manifold, but one that is slightly different than the others. She can be a zigzag, stretched out, or a broken streak. As Lewis argues, time travel is achievable by distinguishing personal time from external time. Personal time is what occupies a certain role in the pattern of events that make up the time traveler's life. When she time travels to the past, this is happening later in her personal time, but earlier in the external time. On the other hand, given that presentism is the view that only present objects exist, this would imply that time travel is not compatible. However, it has been argued that it could be possible to reconcile the two. The nowhere argument says that you cannot travel to somewhere that does not exist. Given that past and future does not exist, time travel is impossible then. However, this would also mean that the ordinary passage of time from one moment to another would not be possible either. We all take journeys to the immediate future, and so the presentist has to account for the passage of time from one moment to the next. While presentists believe that past and future do not exist, most would not rule out the existence of past or future tense truths. It is still true that Taylor Swift won a Grammy in 2021, and it is still true that I will graduate from UCD when I finish my degree. Therefore, what one can do is take the details in the four-dimensional story and include it in the presentist story by expressing it as tense truths. To conclude, this video explored the question of time travel. We explained the views of three-dimensionalists and four-dimensionalists. Following that, we gave arguments showing the compatibility of these views to time travel.